So my name's Steve Dahl, and we're in what I call the Halls of Progress. So this is Drexel University's Papadakis Integrated Sciences building. So we're in the heart of the Department of Biology. So I'm a master's candidate here in the Akins Lab, and what we study in the Akins Lab is Fragile X syndrome. So Fragile X syndrome is a neuropathophysiology which is most commonly associated with autism and intellectual disability. So I am from the Philadelphia area. I've always been interested in science. I've always had a desire to kind of explore the universe, if you will. Even from a young age, you know, when you'd be asked, you know, say what you're interested in, what you'd like to be when you grow up, and you know, people would draw pictures of police officers and firemen and whatnot. I would always draw, you know, a guy in a lab coat. And so I always, you know, from a very young age, wanted to go into science. I love mathematics, and I want to say, you know, and kind of to steal this from Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson. So for those of you who think that you're not good at math, or that you don't understand math, that numbers aren't making sense to you, you have to understand that mathematics is a language, and that it takes multiple years and a lot of time and practice to actually get good at it. I inherently was not a gifted mathematician. Even the people that we consider great thinkers and great mathematicians, you know, we think of Albert Einstein, we think of Stephen Hawking, we think that these guys are, you know, they came out of the womb skilled mathematicians. Well, that really wasn't the case, and that's not the case for anyone. So genius isn't born, and it isn't created. It's worked towards. It's a process. So in my neighborhood, we actually have two boys who suffer from autism, and kind of growing up as, you know, their neighbors and seeing what they had to deal with, it was very eye-opening. So in science, you have people that are interested in exploring the universe and advancing their own intellectual understanding of nature, and then you have people that are interested in not only that aspect but also in improving the human condition. And I'm very much interested in improving the human condition because I've seen how autism affects people firsthand. So some of the techniques that we use here that I use specifically is the polymerase chain reaction, otherwise known as PCR. And the way PCR works is you have a thermophilic, which means a heat tolerant polymerase, a DNA polymerase, which can replicate DNA at very high temperatures. And so you have your sequence of interest, and essentially you introduce this polymerase of interest with nucleotides. The polymerase replicates your sequence of interest, and then you can have essentially billions of copies in one reaction of a particular DNA sequence of interest. So lab life has never been a dark room with blacked out windows. Science is a collaborative effort, and it always has been, as far as I know, a collaborative effort. It's always been based around the flow of ideas, you know, from one mind to another. You're always trying to see how other people are thinking so that you can improve the way you think. Science is the journey, and in order to embark on that journey, you need to have the right backpack. And in that backpack, what I want you to have is intellectual curiosity. I want you to have passion. And the most important tool to have is to not be afraid of being wrong, and to not listen when other people tell you no, because you're going to hear no a lot in your life. People are going to tell you that you're not smart enough. I've been told this myself. You're not gifted. You know, you don't have what it takes. And you just have to say that that's not what it's about. It's not about the standardized tests. It's not about the letters that they put on the papers, A through F. It's about what's going on in here, and it's about what you believe in scientifically. And so that's really what it means to be a scientist, and really what it takes to become a scientist.